and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question which says, the points A with coordinates 4, 5, 10, B with coordinates 2, 3, 4 and C with coordinates 1, 2, minus 1 are three vertices of a parallelogram ABCD. Find the vector equations of the sides AB and BC and also find the coordinates of point D. Suppose we have two points with position vectors 1, 2, A and 1, 2, B, then the vector equation of the line which passes through the given two points is equal to vector R is equal to vector A plus lambda into vector B minus vector A. So vector R equal to vector A plus lambda into vector B minus vector A, the whole is the vector equation of the line which passes through the two points with position vectors vector A and vector B. This is the key idea that we use for this question. Let's move on to the solution now. We have a parallelogram ABCD where the point A has coordinates 4, 5, 10, B has coordinates 2, 3, 4 and C has coordinates 1, 2, minus 1. Now, with reference to O as origin, let the position vector or say position vectors of the points A, B, C and D be given as vector A, vector B, vector C and vector D respectively. First of all, we assume the coordinates of the point D as x, y, z. So we are supposed to find x, y and z as point A has coordinates 4, 5, 10. So vector A, that is the position vector of the point A, would be equal to 4i cap plus 5j cap plus 10k cap. Vector B, that is the position vector of the point B, would be 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap, where 2, 3 and 4 are the coordinates of the point B. Then vector C, which is the position vector of the point C with coordinates 1, 2 and minus 1, would be given as I cap plus 2j cap minus k cap. Vector D, which is the position vector of the point D, would be xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap, where x, y and z are the coordinates of the point D. Now we are supposed to find the vector equations of the lines AB and BC. Now the vector equation of the side AB would be the vector equation of AB that passes through the points A and B, and this is the vector equation of the line which passes through the two points. So vector equation of the side AB, that is this side which passes through the points A and B, would be given by vector R equal to vector A, which is the position vector of the point A, plus lambda into vector B, which is the position vector of the point B, minus vector A the whole. Thus we have vector r equal to 4i cap plus 5j cap plus 10k cap the whole plus lambda into vector b, which is 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap minus vector a, that is minus 4i cap minus 5j cap minus 10k cap the whole, which means vector r is equal to 4i cap plus 5j cap plus 10k cap the whole plus lambda into 2i cap minus 4i cap is minus 2i cap, 3j cap minus 5j cap is minus 2j cap, 4k cap minus 10k cap is minus 6k cap. This gives us vector r is equal to 4i cap plus 5j cap plus 10k cap minus 2 lambda into I cap plus j cap plus 3k cap the whole. This can also be written as vector r is equal to 4i cap plus 5j cap plus 10k cap plus say lambda 1 into I cap plus j cap plus 3k cap the whole, where we have taken lambda 1 as minus 2 lambda. Thus, vector equation of the side AB is given as vector r equal to 4i cap plus 5j cap plus 10k cap the whole plus lambda 1 into I cap plus j cap plus 3k cap the whole. In the same way, we find out the vector equation of the side BC is given as vector r equal to vector b plus lambda into vector c minus vector b the whole, where vector b is the position vector of the point B, vector c is the position vector of the point C. Putting the values of vector b and vector c, we get vector r is equal to vector b, which is 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap, the whole plus lambda into vector c, which is I cap plus 2j cap minus k cap minus vector b, that is minus 2i cap minus 3j cap minus 4k cap the whole. So this gives us vector r is equal to 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap the whole plus lambda into I cap minus 2i cap is minus I cap, 2j cap minus 3j cap is minus j cap, minus k cap minus 4k cap is minus 5k cap the whole. So here further we have vector r is equal to 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap the whole minus lambda into I cap plus j cap plus 5k cap the whole. So we have the vector equation of the side BC is given as vector r equal to 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap plus lambda 2, that is in place of minus lambda we take lambda 2, into I cap plus j cap plus 5k cap the whole. And here we have lambda 2 as minus lambda. Next we will find the coordinates of the point D. Here we have BD and AC are the diagonals of the parallelogram ABCD. Now, since the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other, therefore, the midpoint of the diagonal BD would be equal to the midpoint of the diagonal AC. This means the midpoint of diagonal BD would be given as vector OB plus vector OD this whole upon 2 equal to the midpoint of diagonal AC, which is given as vector OA plus vector OC this whole upon 2. This means that vector OB plus vector OD is equal to vector OA plus vector OC. This vector OB means the position vector of the point B with reference to the origin O, that is vector B plus OD, that is vector OD is the position vector of the point D, that is vector D is equal to vector OA, which is vector A, that is the position vector of the point A, plus vector OC, that is vector C, which is the position vector of the point C. Computing the respective values of the vectors A, B, C and D, we get 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap plus xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap is equal to 4i cap plus 5j cap plus 10k cap plus I cap plus 2j cap minus k cap. So this gives us xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap is equal to, now 4i cap plus I cap is 5i cap, 5j cap plus 2j cap is plus 7j cap, 10k cap minus k cap is plus 9k cap minus 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. So this gives us xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap is equal to 5i cap minus 2i cap is 3i cap, 7j cap minus 3j cap is 4j cap, 9k cap minus 4k cap is plus 5k cap. So this is the position vector of the point D. So from here we have x as 3, y as 4 and z as 5. Thus the point D has coordinates 3, 4, 5. So this is our answer. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.